The sun is out here in the 5A State Championship. Hello everyone, I'm RJ Honk along with Bobby Swafford for today's game between Marion and Van Buren at the Benton Athletic Complex. And boy, we have had some dandies of games over the last 2 days here at the Athletic Complex. And I would imagine we're going to have the same type of game that we've seen so far. Both these teams between Van Buren and Marion put up a lot of runs. 7 runs apiece do both these teams put up. And we'll start with Marion, Bobby. And this is a team, it's their first trip to the finals, and they've gotten better each and every year. This is a team that, going back to 2018, they started with 18 wins, and they went with 21. Then they had the COVID year. 21, they got 24 wins, and this year they're 28-5.
And they're playing their best baseball of the season at the absolute right time. This is the state championship that I had circled for the weekend that is probably going to be the best, at least featuring the two best teams from their classification. But for Marion, they haven't given up a run in 5 games. They've won 15 straight. They haven't lost since April the 9th, a span of 52 days. How do they handle the pressure of being in a state championship game against the defending champion? Well, they handled the state tournament pretty well. How about wins of 10-0, 5-0, and 7-0 over some pretty good squads?
Yeah, it's a heck of a job that these Patriots have done. Let's go to the flip side now with Van Buren. They come in 26-5 on the year. They are the defending state champions, and we've got a highlight reel from last year when they were right here at the Benton Athletic Complex. And boy, I tell you what, they were bombing away in that game last year. I would imagine having a little bit more familiarity with this ballpark, they have a little comfort factor here.
Yeah, and they came in and jumped on Jonesboro early last year. Then the rains came, and then the flood of runs came for the Pointers as they routed Jonesboro 12-1 in that championship game. And they haven't really slowed down either. They're playing their best baseball this year at the right time. They've won 12 of 13, and that's what they're hoping to do again today, because that dog pile feels pretty good when it's the last game of the season.
Unless you're the person at the very bottom.
Exactly. That's very true.
It doesn't feel very good. But, hey, you know, these two teams met last year, and Marion lost to Van Buren in the second round last year, and they're hoping to avenge that loss. Let's go ahead and take a look at the starting lineups for Marion, and then we'll get the Van Buren pitcher here in just a second. But Marion's lineup so far is really a dominant lineup, Bobby. This is a lineup for Marion that you've got 6 guys going to play college baseball somewhere. Gage Watson leads the way, and he's a guy going to Mizzou to play. Then you've got Peyton Boyles, Dylan Kite, Chase Armstrong, Connor Taylor, Matthew Kearney, Luke Bullens, Connor Brinkley, and Caleb Catt. Of that, 6 of those guys are headed to play college baseball.
Yeah, you mentioned Gage Watson going to the University of Missouri. Also, Chase Armstrong, who we're going to see on the mound, going to Arkansas State. So they got some talent, but the Pointers do on the other side as well.
Gavin Gaddis is the starting pitcher today for Van Buren. He comes in working 68 2/3 innings. He's 9-2 on the year with a 1.83 ERA. He's at 80 strikeouts with 24 walks. He's left 59 runners on the bags this baseball season. We're just underway as Gage Watson is under in the batter's box, and he'll take a first pitch strike.
You mentioned the numbers for Devin Gaddis. He's not going to overpower you. He's, you know, velocity's probably just average, but you saw the bender as he opened up there. He can control the breaking ball, and that gets him ahead.
Fastball at 92, misses outside, and it's 1-1. As we said, Gaddis going to the University of Missouri next year. Batting 276 with 3 home runs and 27 RBIs. That misses outside, and it's 2-1.
Doesn't matter if you played this game last year. Of course, nerves are going to be there for both teams. We've seen it already this weekend, RJ. Who settles in first?
There's another curveball that swung on out to second base. Dudley's got it. He lost the handle on it on the exchange. And so Watson's on the bags with an error by the second baseman.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. Just a simple ground ball. Should be a routine 4-3 put out in the scorebook. But instead, Dudley can't control it. Loses the handle of it. And Marion has the leadoff man on thanks to the error.
So Peyton Voiles is up next as he's batting 281 with 5 home runs and 18 RBI this year. He'll be headed to Graceland College. I can only imagine where Graceland is.
Is there a pink Cadillac out in front of the park?
Runner at first base, he shows bunt, pulls it back, and it's outside for a ball. On deck is Dylan Kite. Just underway here in the 5A state championship game. As Voiles is going to show bunt again, and it'll be low, and brings the count to 2-0.
This Marion team has a little patience, not a ton. 150 walks drawn this year. They've struck out 254 times. Gaddis has got to come attack now, down 2-0 in the count.
2-0 is in there for a strike. Tell you one thing, Boyle's better watch out, because he stands in that box after the bunt, and he's pumped. The catcher, Connor Brady's pumped twice, and he's been in the way both times.
Yeah, Watson's taking a pretty big secondary lead over at first.
A throw back to first. They're going to try to hold him on, and Watson's a guy that has been known to steal a few bases if he gets on. There's a 2-1. That swung on and fouled off the ankle.
It's a good job by Gaddis to fight back after falling behind in the count to start. Two good pitches. Evens up the count to two apiece.
Two balls, two strikes as we are in the top of the first inning. A throwback over to first base. The defensive alignment for Van Buren. You've got Eli Gilruth at third base. Brecken Waters at short. Dylan Dudley at second base. And Jackson Rodert at first base. Here's the 2-2 as it's outside to make the count 3-2. In the outfield, Presley Nichols is in left for Van Buren. Kai Henry's in center, and Joshua Nowotny is in right field with Connor Brady back behind the dish. Here's the 3-2, and it's a ball outside, and now Marion has runners at first and second after the walk.
That's exactly what you want the top of your order to do. Find a way to get on base. Watson puts the ball in play, reaches on the air, now moves over to second because of the base on balls. Gaddis has to settle in. Can't afford to give up a big inning early.
Dylan Kite comes to the plate. He's the catcher today. 341 average, two home runs, 21 RBI. Headed to Rich Mountain, University of Arkansas, Rich Mountain, that is. You'll see a fastball at 92 on the inside half, and it's 0-1.
You know, for those of you who haven't heard of UA Rich Mountain, new junior college in the last few years. Do a nice job of recruiting across the state. Giving some high school kids from our state a chance to play at the next level.
Here's the 0-1. Slider in there. Nice job at 71. It's 0-2.
The breaking ball's been there for Gaddis. It's the fastball he hasn't quite commanded.
0-2. That's swung on and missed, and that's the first out here in the first inning.
Big, big bounce back at bat there for the Van Buren pitcher, Devin Gaddis. Good morning, good afternoon, good night. Big strikeout for the first out of the frame.
So now Chase Armstrong comes up. Now he's the pitcher today for Marion. Batting 305 with seven home runs and 34 RBI. Armstrong headed to Arkansas State next year to play baseball. First pitch is swung on and lifted into left center field. That's going way back, all the way to the warning track, and bounces off the bottom of the wall. Runners had to hold up because they didn't know if the outfielder was going to get to it. Now bases are loaded for Connor Taylor.
Chase Armstrong gave that one a drive, hits it to the deepest part of the ballpark, but he knows Kai Henry can track it down. Has to wait to make sure that one's not caught. That's why the runner can't score on one of the longest singles you'll ever see.
Yeah, that went a long way. You know, around the field, it's 320 down the line, 355 in the gaps, 375 at dead center. And it hit right there, probably about 360, as we've got a balk, and so that's going to score a run. So Watson comes in to score after the balk. That'll put Boyles at third base, Armstrong at second base.
You can see the umpire in the field there make the signal, saying that he didn't pause long enough before he started his motion towards the plate. The rules of the block, and it's a freebie for the Patriots.
So now Connor Taylor, the first baseman, is at the plate, batting 267 with a home run and 19 RBI. curveball in there, called a strike. Swung on and missed. Boy, he has got some dirty stuff. When he's in the zone, it makes it look like it's coming in as a fastball. It just falls off the table.
Yeah, has really good command of that breaking ball. It's the fastball that Marion's been able to jump on.
So no balls, two strikes for Connor Taylor. There's one out here in the top of the first inning. That's chopped high to first base. They'll throw it back home, and he's safe.
The great job by Voiles. He was going on contact. The big hop took just enough time to land in the glove of the first baseman, Jackson Rodert. His throw just a touch late, and Marion pushes another one across.
So it's an RBI for Connor Taylor. Matthew Kearney's up next.
Goes down as a fielder's choice in the scorebook. Also going to prompt a mound visit for the Van Buren coaching staff.
So Armstrong is going to be at third base with Taylor at first. Kearney's at the plate. Kearney's only batting 188 this year. He's got the lowest average in the starting lineup. If you're the head coach, Luke Weatherford, right now, what are you telling your starting pitcher?
It's got to settle in. I mean, you're not only talking with your pitcher, you're talking to your infield as well. Because, I mean, likely that's a play that Rodert should step on first base and get the sure out and make sure you get the second out of the inning, because he wasn't playing in. He was behind the bag, so it was going to be a difficult play for him to make. To settle down, make the easy play, make the easy throw, make sure you're doing the right things to get yourself out of this inning and avoid a huge frame by Marion.
Yeah, I was a little shocked that he didn't touch the bag because, I mean, he was standing right beside it when he caught it.
Literally two steps away from it.
So the third baseman, Matthew Kearney, is in the plate.
Now batting, the third baseman, number 25, Matthew Kearney.
So far, Marion, two runs, one hit. He puts down a bunt down the first base side. Pitcher has to run a long way, gets the flip, runs, scores. And so now it's 3-0 after the sacrifice bunt, and that'll put Connor Taylor at second base.
That is perfect execution there for Matthew Kearney. Lays the bunt down, does his job, and pushes in a run across.
Left fielder number 24, Luke Bowens.
So now Luke Bowens is at the plate. He's the left fielder today, batting 302, and that one will get out to short. He'll have to make a long play, but he sails it. Sails it all the way to the dugout of Marion, and that'll score a run, and that'll put Bowens at second base.
It was a great diving stop by Brecken Waters out at short. Just tried to rush the throw too much. That one sails all the way into the Marion dugout, and another run comes to Strauss to score for the Patriots.
So it's a single for Bowens, but then with the error, he's going to go to second base. And now Connor Brinkley is going to be at the plate. Well, this one's getting out of hand quick here in the first inning.
Yeah, pair of errors for Van Buren leading to a couple runs. Marion's doing what they're supposed to. They're putting the ball in play, putting some pressure on this Van Buren defense.
And Brinkley showed a bunt. He missed it, and it's 0-1.
There's good things are going to happen when you put the ball in play.
Brinkley, who is headed to Southwest Tennessee Junior College. One is outside. On deck is Caleb Catt. One one's a fastball outside. It's now 2-1. 2-1 is a curveball that misses outside, and it's now 3-1.
Already 23 pitches in this first inning for Gaddis.
Another curveball, and he's going to walk.
If you have a blueprint for what you don't want to do in the open inning, Van Buren would probably point to this. A pair of walks, a pair of errors, four runs across for Marion, and your pitcher's already having a labor on a hot day here in Central Arkansas.
So now the ninth batter of the inning is Caleb Catt. He's a right fielder batting 250. Runners at first and second. Curveball is going to miss outside. Fastball caught the outside corner. That time it's 76. There's a curveball in there for a strike. It's 1-2 now. That misses outside, and it's now 2-2. Well, the crazy thing about this is Devin Gaddis came into the ballgame with a 9-2 record with a 1.83 ERA. Here's the 2-2. That's swung on and driven into left center. That's going all the way back, and he's going to run for a little while. It hit off the bottom of the wall. One run scores. Two run scores. He's going to have a triple, a stand-up triple.
Marion just found it a way to put the ball in the power alley. Twice now they've put it out to the deepest part of the park in left center field. That time they go opposite field, and that's just a good-looking swing. Stays down on it and drives it the other way. And just get on the merry-go-round for the Patriots, as they push across two more runs.
And so they batted around, and now back to the top of the lineup goes Gage Watson, and it looks like they're going to make a pitching change. As Coach Weatherford makes his way to the mound. And they're going to have a conversation. I was wanting to look on the Marion stats to see if for Caleb Catt. That is Catt's first triple of the season. And I said they were going to make a pitching change, but they're going to leave Devin Gaddis in there.
Six runs on three hits, two errors, also a pair of walks in this first inning for Marion. If you're wearing red, white, and blue today, everything has gone your way so far.
First pitch to Watson is outside.
But as we saw last night, RJ, in the 4A state championship game, there is a lot of baseball left.
Yeah. 1-0 swung on and ripped into right field. Another run scores. So, Bobby, you look down the lineup card. And everybody has scored except for two players.
Well, you mentioned the stats that Marion's put up all season long. You got to be able to hit from top to bottom. That's why they're in the state championship game. 10-0 over Whitehall, 5-0 over Benton, 7-0 over Sheridan. That's their resume to get to the title game in the state tournament.
There's a foul tip off the ankle for Peyton Boyles.
And they're not slowing down today.
Well, if you are Chase Armstrong, the pitcher for Marion, coming into the game, he hadn't even been on the mound yet. And to come in, and you've got a seven-run cushion to work with. Can't have many nerves when you have that kind of cushion.
Yeah.
That swung on and fouled off.
The only complaint he could have is he's having to wait too long before he gets on the mounds.
Yeah, he may have to warm up again.
We're about at 18 minutes for the top half of this frame.
Right now, Devin Gaddis has thrown 33 pitches here in the first inning. And mind you, Bobby, they've done all these runs, well, the majority of the runs, with two outs. As a throw down to second, gets away, and he's going to head to third now. And there was nobody covering the third base bag. And so Watson's going to go all the way to third base, and it's going to be an error.
They're going to rule the strikeout, so all that's negated.
Okay, I didn't see the official plate called a strikeout. So either way, Boyle strikes out, and that's going to retire the side. But not until Marion puts up seven runs off four base hits. There were two errors. We head to the bottom of the first inning, where Van Buren's going to get a shot at him now. You're watching the Centennial Bank State Baseball Championships at Arkansas PBS Sports.
Can you see her greatness? When you attend her games, when you cheer her on, or when you participate in any way, you support your community and make it better, and you will see her greatness. Join us as we pledge to increase the visibility of women's sports in our communities. It makes a difference when we all are involved. At Everett Butte GMC, we proudly support our local female athletes and encourage you to do the same. See her greatness.
This month in Passport on the PBS video app.
Of creativity and intelligence that is civilization's greatest gift.
Was outburst of tear gas.
The real story of the March to Selma.
She became aware of the power of television to misinform people.
Maybe a re-examination of what is normal is in order at this
These
point.
These and other shows from Arkansas PBS are available with Passport on the PBS video app.
Back here in Benton, as it's 7-0. Marion leads Van Buren. Now it's Van Buren's time at the plate. Let's go over the starting lineup for Van Buren. And they will start with Kai Henry, the center fielder. Presley Nichols, the left fielder, is batting second. Eli Gilreth is the third baseman, batting third. Connor Brady is the catcher in the cleanup spot. Then you've got Jackson Roberts, the first baseman. The DH today is Hayden Hurst, who's batting sixth. Brecken Waters, the shortstop, batting seventh. Joshua Nowotny is the eighth batter. And then Devin Gaddis, the pitcher, is batting ninth.
If you're Van Buren, that lineup you just went through, RJ, chip away. Yeah, you're not going to be able to hit any seven-run homers today, yeah, unfortunately. So you just got to start to chip away at this lead. Hope your pitching staff and your defense settles in.
So Kai Henry's up first, and he'll have one sail over his head.
There's a lot of time left in this contest. A lot of baseball to be played.
Here's the 1-0. That goes over his head as well.
I think Armstrong's a little juiced up.
Yeah.
And two that he just tries to overthrow, leaves at the top of the zone. Kai Henry's got to keep his head on a swivel.
Now Bobby, remind me, is this the same Kai Henry's that is the wide receiver for the football team?
It is. Had an outstanding season. He has got college prospect written all over him. Already got a few offers. I know Central Arkansas, a few from the Ivy League have offered him.
Here's the 2-0. That's inside and it misses. It's 3-0.
Good athlete, good football family. Dad just got promoted to head coach for the Pointers. Future is bright for Kai.
Here's the 3-0 pitch. That is a little high, and so that's going to be a leadoff walk for Kai Henry.
And as you might imagine, he's got speed to burn on the base pass. 15 stolen bases caught just three times this year, so keep an eye on number one over at first and see if he decides to try to swipe a free bag.
So Presley Nichols is up next. He's the left fielder, batting 266 with two home runs and 26 RBI. That one comes in at 87 miles an hour on a fastball, but it misses outside.
Yeah, if you're Van Buren and you're Presley Nichols here, I'm sitting here. I'm not taking the bat off my shoulder until Armstrong proves to me he can throw a strike. He started this contest with five consecutive balls.
1-0, there's a strike with a fastball at 88 on the inside.
That's called speaking it into existence.
Yeah. He's by far been the hardest thrower that we've seen this weekend. He's touching 88. One, swung on, out to second base, and he bobbled it. Everybody's safe. That time, the second baseman for Marion, Boyles, he looked at second before he took the exchange, and now you've got runners at first and second.
Very similar start to what we had on the other side. A walk and an error. The previous inning was an error, then a walk.
So now Eli Gilreth, the third baseman, comes to the plate, batting 352 with two home runs and 20 RBI. But Bobby, get this, he leads the team in on-base percentage at 524.
Shows that he's got patience at the plate.
And he swings at one on the outside at 90 miles an hour.
Contact rate is a number that I like to look at in the on-base percentage and, you know, look at the number of strikeouts. Van Buren's going to put the bat on the ball, put some pressure on a defense, and they're going to have to certainly do that today to try to get back in this contest.
Here's the 0-1 curveball. And it's in there at 65 miles an hour. Boy, you go from 90 to 65. That's slowing things down.
It's almost impossible as a hitter to convince yourself to swing at it.
Yeah. Another fastball outside, gets past the catcher, and runners will now be at second and third.
Armstrong just may be a little juiced up on the mound. He's got to settle in. His command has not been there here in the home half of the first.
One ball, two strikes. Fastball misses outside. It's now 2-2. That's swung on. A high fly ball. It's going to go right in front of the Marion dugout. He catches it for the out. That's a lot of foul territory that he had to go to, but he got the out.
That's a big first out there to retire the three-hole hitter. You mentioned the on-base percentage. Anytime you can retire Eli Gilreth, you've done a job.
Now the cleanup hitter, Connor Brady, is going to be at the plate, batting 350 with two home runs and 28 RBI. Curveball in the dirt. Here's the 1-0. That swung on. It was kind of a check swing that fouled off. Bobby, you know, you and I have talked a lot about this turf field here in Benton. And if you notice at home plate, they've got those rugs that they're kind of detachable. You can kind of see them right there on this screen. As the 1-1 comes, and it's inside high and tight, brings the count to 2-1. While I was talking with Mark Ballesteri, and he said when those things got put in, he said they didn't really stick all that well initially. And so the first game that they played on them, they had a kid from Benton that came running in. He slid, and he said he rolled it up. It looked like a fruit roll-up when he rolled it up. As that one's high and went 3-1, he said, he rolled it up and it was all gravel, and he slid on the gravel to home plate. He said it sticks now, though.
Yeah. After a kid would go through the asphalt, you would imagine they're going to try to put some super glue down.
It is Velcro holding that down. Here's the 3-1, and it's now 3-2 after the swing.
Yeah, Connor Brady was sitting dead red fastball on that one, swung through it. If you're Van Buren, you got to find a way to push both these runs across that are in scoring position with one out and start to chip away at this Marion touchdown advantage.
Here's the 3-2 pitch. That swung on, popped up on the infield. The shortstop, Brinkley's calling for it, and he's got it. So now there's two outs in the inning with runners at second and third, and Jackson Rodert's at the plate, the first baseman. batting 325, three now home runs and 21 RBI.
Number 31, Jackson Roeder.
As that one's outside, it's 1-0. That's at 91, misses Hines, 2-0.
Yeah, the velocity certainly there for Armstrong. You can see why he's committed to play at the next level. He's got a live arm. He's certainly missed up in the zone here in this first.
2-0's on the way. That's outside, 91 again. Doesn't really matter how fast you throw it. If you can't throw strikes,
that'll locate.
So the count's 3-0. That's in there for a strike at 90. Three and one's on the way. And it's at the knees, called a strike. The count's full at 3-2 now.
Big pitch coming up right here for Chase Armstrong. Even though he hasn't had the best of command, if he can find a way to get out of this inning without allowing a run, he's going to feel pretty good about the rest of his day.
3-2. Swung on and fouled off. Came back with the fastball.
Four pitches now for Armstrong. So both of these pitchers having to work in the opening frame.
Reaches on the way. Curveball, and he walks him.
That is an outstanding at bat from Jackson Roeder, because that took a heck of a patience there to not swing at that or offer at that pitch, because that looked like a strike about 50 feet to the plate in the last 10 or 15 feet, just dropped off the edge of the table.
Yeah, I mean, it's a ball. I mean, that's a great shot by our camera guys. So now Hayden Hurst, the DH, is up. Fastball that's low. Here's the 1-0. There's the fastball in there. Took something off that one at 88. It's now 1-1.
Find a way to just settle down. Bases loaded, a huge spot for Van Buren. Find a way to push across one or a couple.
Here's the 1-1. Curveball. That's in there for a strike. Two strikes, swung on, popped up back behind home plate. Keeps count at 1-2. You know, none of these runners are earned runs, as curveball misses inside. It's 2-2.
Six of the seven in the opening inning were unearned for Marion. And if Van Buren happens to push anything across here, they would be unearned as well.
So the count's 3-2.
I think they're having a little bit of discussion what the count actually is.
So the umpire says 3-2. I've got 2-2 on my book.
Yeah, they just adjusted the scoreboard. Now they're going to get together and converse.
Yeah, I mean, I had 2-2 on my book. I think the officials are now looking up the scores.
Yep, the official scorebook is here in the press box. So now the home plate umpire going to go get confirmation from right there.
So 2-2.
Four pitches we've seen in the first inning today.
You know, we're not done yet. In the game that we did earlier today, we didn't have 64 pitches through the fifth inning. Here's the 2-2, and that's a little chin music.
Yeah, that's big, too, because now the runners are going to go on first movement. She put one in the gap. Van Buren could push three across.
Three twos high, and that'll score a run.
It's good patient there by Waters. Works the count, earns the walk, and gets a cheap RBI in the process.
So that will put Nichols at third base, Rodert at second, and Hurst at first. Now we're going to have a meeting of the mound.
When Armstrong is missing, he's missing up, RJ.
Yeah.
And it's consistently, and through this contest, I mean, he's walked three now, hasn't allowed a hit. And Van Buren has pushed across the run and has the bases loaded. So they're all self-inflicted wounds out there on the mound. And that's what his coach has got to be telling him. He's like, look, they're not beating you. You're currently beating yourself. Just finish the throw. Bend at the waist. No, I'm not a pitching coach. You can't tell him exactly what his fundamentals are wrong, but let's go ahead and finish it. Throw the ball over the plate and make them beat you.
So Brecken Waters, the shortstop's up next, batting 264 on the year with 11 RBI. There's two outs here in the seventh.
Number three, Brecken Waters.
Score is 7-1. Inside, 1-0. That's swung out, and to the gap in left center. One run will score, two runs will score, and runners are going to be at first and second.
A great job by Waters there. Just sits down on it and drives it right back up the middle. Picks up two RBIs, and Van Buren right back in this contest.
That was a good piece of hitting right there by Brecken Waters. And that's the first base hit for Van Buren here in this game. And now the eight-hole hitter, Josh Nowotny, is going to be at the plate.
That's the big hit that Van Buren's been looking for. He can't afford, especially after giving up seven in the top of the first. Can't afford to leave the bases loaded.
And Bobby, think about this. These three runs are the first runs that Marion's given up the entire state tournament.
Yep. So how do they handle this adversity? They haven't had any adversity really in 50 days. Haven't lost since April the 9th. You know, sure, they've got a seven, they had a 7-0 lead, but well, not everything's going your way. How do you handle it? But it's a hot day, especially on that turf.
You think it's a little bit, and I guess we should ask Coach Ballesteri this, you think it's a little bit different pitching on a turf mound than one that's made with dirt?
I don't think so, because a lot of times you'll see that like an indoor facility, yeah, they're pitching off turf on a wooden platform.
Yeah.
So as long as the elevation's the same, which it is, it shouldn't be that big of a difference.
Nowotny fouls the first pitch he sees off. There's that mat that we were talking about. That's not the one that got rolled up, though, when they were sliding into home, but it's identical to that. Here's the 0-1. Curveball hits him. So now you've got bases loaded with the 9-hole hitter coming up.
Yeah, just another free pass. Three walks and a hit batter in this inning to go along with the one base hit.
Devin Gaddis, the pitcher, and boy, you got to think he's feeling a lot better right now.
Yeah, if he can get out here and help his cause, he's going to certainly feel a lot better about the way the first half of this inning went.
Now batting, the pitcher, number 42, Devin Gaddis.
Gaddis on the year batting 255 with 17 RBI. That swung on and missed.
That one was right down Main Street, and Gaddis couldn't put the barrel on it.
That swung on miss, 0-2. Boy, Gaddis looks like a grown man. He's got that beard going.
I can't grow that beard at 38.
Yeah. Looks like he's been in the workforce for a few years. Here's the 0-2. And he fouls that one off. Just stuck the end of the bat out there to foul it off.
And Armstrong's not wasting any time at this bat. This is just three straight fastballs have caught a majority of the plate.
Chase Armstrong now has thrown 39 pitches. Foul tipped into the glove of the catcher. And that's going to do it for the bottom of the first inning, but not until Van Buren. They put three runs themselves on the board. Off a one base hit, they left three. We head to the top of the second inning where Marion leads Van Buren 7-3. You're watching the Centennial Bank State Baseball Championships on Arkansas PBS Sports.
And Merchants Bank and the Bank of Fayetteville share the mission of Arkansas PBS to enrich and empower all Arkansans. Community, dignity, respect. That's what me banking is all about. More at mebanking.com.
Since 1976, McCormick Equipment Rental and Sales has been equipping Arkansans for the tough jobs, construction equipment and rentals, service and sales, and a proud underwriter of Arkansas PBS Sports.
Well, let's go back and take a look at, go down memory lane and look at that first inning, because there was a lot that happened as it took 46 minutes to play the first inning, and it was run after run after run for Marion, and they put up a seven spot in the top of the first inning. I mean, they were banging hits off the wall. I mean, everybody, there were smiles everywhere.
74 pitches, 10 total runs, and Van Buren already having to go to the bullpen.
Yeah.
Here in the second inning, runs aplenty. They're checking on it. That might be the most runs ever scored combined between two teams in the state championship game.
So now the new pitcher for Van Buren is going to be Eli Gilreth. And Gilreth was in the lineup as the third baseman. And so now he'll be the pitcher for today's contest.
Gilreth actually has thrown the most innings of any Van Buren player this season, 69 innings of work, an ERA of 1.8, struck out 74 batters, and walked just 15, 18 earned runs allowed, a record of 10-1 on the season.
Looks like at third base, Dylan Dudley has moved over to third. As the first pitch is swung on and missed by Dylan Kite.
I think it's a smart move by Coach Weatherford to go ahead and go to the bullpen now. Everybody in the Marion lineup had seen Gaddis.
It's over into right field for a base hit.
As I finished that thought, everybody had already seen Gaddis one time through the lineup, so maybe give them a different look, but apparently it doesn't matter as Dylan Kite smokes that one through the hole on the right side.
By the way, Devin Gaddis now playing second base for the Van Buren Pointers. So that brings to the plate Chase Armstrong. He singled to center field back in the first inning. It was a long
first
single all the way to the wall.
Number 19, Slade Inman. Now batting the pitcher number 32, Chase Armstrong.
So this note just got passed to me. That first inning, and I'll tell you this after this at bat. That swung on and missed. So that first inning, we put up 10 total runs, right? It's the second most in a state championship game.
In an inning.
Ever in an inning. The first, the number one spot belongs to Parker's Chapel in Junction City in 2011. They put up 12 total runs. Parker's Chapel had an 11 spot in the first inning. That swung on and missed, 0-2.
Shout out to Walter Woody for the quick research.
Tay, he is a wealth of knowledge.
You don't even want to go down the rabbit hole what he's got on a hard drive as far as historical documents and stats going back in every sport in the state of Arkansas.
Here's the 0-2 as that's a changeup outside. It's now 1-2. Runner at first base. We're in the top of the second inning. A throw over to first, ball got away briefly. You know, Bobby, they were calling for weather for this ball game, and it looks like it's kind of starting to either go around us or go away, one of the two.
Clear skies, a little bit off to our left. The wind's blowing pretty hard out there in the flag and right.
Here's the 1-2, ripped out to left field. Another base hit. And now Marion's got runners at first and second. That's back-to-back singles for Chase Armstrong. And now Connor Taylor comes to the plate.
Back-to-back base hits to start this second inning.
First runner for the pitcher, number 22, Landon Miller. Now batting first baseman, number 11, Connor Taylor.
Landon Miller, by the way, is going to run for Armstrong at first base.
Armstrong's been busy. Pair of hits already. Also threw 40 pitches.
There's another one into right field. And they're going to make a throw home, and everybody's going to stay at first, second, and third.
Nice strong throw in there from Nowotny in the outfield to keep the runner at third base, but a base is loaded already again for Marion, and nobody out here in the second.
So now Matthew Kearney comes to the plate. He had a sack bunt back in the first inning, which got him an RBI.
Matthew Kearney.
Now he'll step up with bases juiced. Here on the top of the second inning with no outs. That swung on and popped up into foul territory. And the catcher, Connor Brady, couldn't quite get to it. So it's 0-1.
Have not had the luxury, Van Buren, their pitching staff and their defense, had the luxury of having an easy at-bat to this point. Only two batters have stepped up to the plate with nobody on base, and that was the leadoff man for both innings.
Marion's now brought their hit count up to 7, so they've got 7 runs off 7 hits. There's the 0-1, curve ball in there for a strike.
Need strikeouts here if you're Gilreth. Can't afford Marion to put the ball in play and push across any more runs. understand the Van Buren's got six innings left, and they put three up in the first. But the hole you dig yourself can only get so large.
There's a foul tip. Counts 0-2.
You saw a team rally back from 5-0 yesterday. Team scored four in the seventh to tie the game. Force extra innings.
By the way, I want to say hello to my buddy Ethan Robinson up in Atkins, who's watching today's ball game. Hate to hear about the softball team that lost earlier.
Middle innings for Ashdown is just a little too much for the Lady Devils to overcome.
0-2 is the count with bases loaded. And there's a strikeout for Eli Gilruth.
Big pitch there, just painted the black on the outside. Huge first out of this frame.
So now that brings up Luke Bullens, the left fielder.
That's good placement there. It's a really good pitch, and Kearney knew it.
Bullens had a single back in the first inning. As the first pitch misses outside. Here's the 1-0. Fastball misses outside. Boy, the delivery process for Gilruth is a lot slower than what we saw out of Devin Gattis.
Yeah, I actually saw Marion step out a few times trying to slow Gattis' delivery down. And Gilruth certainly much more methodical getting the signals, but also with runners in scoring position out at second base. Got to go through the signals to make sure they're not swiping signs.
Here's the 2-0. It misses outside. It's 3-0.
Slight wardrobe malfunction.
You know, those uniforms are... Oh, he lost a button. As hot as it is, he'd probably just rather wear that T-shirt.
Yeah.
So, we're going to try to get him a safety pin to put his jersey back together.
So, we have a legit wardrobe malfunction.
I mean,
no offense to Mr. Gilruth, he does not look like Janet Jackson, but this is a family-friendly show.
So does his catcher have a pin that he's giving him? I think the catcher had a pin on his jersey, and so he said, "Here, you can have my safety pin." Get the pointer some buttons.
Seen a lot of delays in my day.
I've never seen a wardrobe malfunction. I mean,
speaking of wardrobes, I don't know if we can get a shot of this guy. He's on the Van Buren side, standing in the front row, and he's in a makeshift jumpsuit with cutoff shorts.
Yeah.
It is something that I want to see again, but also never see again.
Yeah. Well, he's cool, I'll tell you that much.
That's true.
I mean, at this point, could you not trade out a jersey with somebody that's on the bench?
You could. And of course, you got it. There's who we're talking about. That's a work of art, I guess. But you change jerseys, and you've got to change the number in the official scorebook. And
yeah, I mean, it just seems a lot easier than going through safety pins.
Yeah.
Yeah, that guy in the stands, he put some effort into that. Make sure it's the right length.
He's got the accessories, got the sweatbands on the upper arm to make the muscles look bigger. I mean, he planned this out. There's no doubt about it.
Okay, back to action. And he'll walk Bullens. And that'll walk in a run.
Second RBI in as many innings for Bullens.
So that'll put Armstrong at third base. It'll put Taylor at second with Bullens at first. And now at the plate is going to be Connor Brinkley. And that swung on and ripped to right field. It'll be in for a base hit. One run will score. And they'll hold Taylor up at third. And now we've got another run on the books here in the second.
Yep, just a merry-go-round that was rolling so well in the first inning, doing again here in the second. Starting to see why this Marion baseball squad is 29-5 on the season and hasn't lost in more than a month.
Caleb Catt, the nine-hole hitter's up, and he got a triple back in the first inning. He'll watch a ball sail low. Hey, there's not been much of a rhythm to this ball game.
We are 54 minutes into it, and we've recorded 7 outs.
Here's the 1-0. That's down low, and it's 2-0. Here's the 2-0 pitch, and it's outside, 3-0. So 3 balls, no strikes. And it's the 4th ball. That'll walk in another run. So now that'll send Bullens to third base with Brinkley at second and Catt at first base.
That's what you can't afford to do as a pitching staff, just give up free bases and force across runs.
So now Luke Weatherford, the head coach, going to make his way out and talk with his pitcher, Eli Gilruth. You know, they batted around in the first inning, and they're 2 batters away from doing it again.
10 runs on 8 hits. You look at the stat sheet, though. The Van Buren's just already walked 4 batters, a couple of errors. They're just not doing themselves any favors, are the Pointers.
Well, we're in the top of the second inning. It's 10-3. And here's the thing, Bobby. If you look at the state tournament run for Marion, I mean, they're kind of doing what they did throughout there as far as lots of big scores. Had 10 runs against Whitehall. They had 5 against Benton and then 7 against Sheridan.
Van Buren just got to settle down the pitching staff. I mean, just throw strikes, trust your defense. Because you get past Gilruth, and the experience as far as the pitching numbers goes drastically down. Only Presley Nichols has pitched more than 30 innings, according to the stats given to us by Coach Weatherford.
Now batting the center fielder, number 1, Gage Watson.
So Gage Watson is now at the plate. He's the leadoff guy. And today he's had a single, and he got on in the first inning because of an error by the second baseman. First pitch is outside low. It's ball 1. And Bobby, if you're a batter right now for Marion, just kind of stand there until you get some strikes.
Yeah, just make him throw you something over the plate. Clearly struggling to find the zone.
Here's the 1-0, swung on, ripped to right field, and it's going to be foul.
Or just swing away and hammer one right down the right field line. What do we know?
Yeah.
You know a pitcher's struggling to find the strike zone, so you assume that he's going to try to throw one over the plate, and it's just so hard as a hitter when you see it and you think it's in the zone that you want to just tell yourself not to swing at it. Whether you've got the red light from the coaching staff or not, you just want to let it fly, especially when the bases are loaded.
1-1's the count. That one sails way outside, and it's 2-1. Runner at first, second, and third for Marion. One out here in the top of the second. That's fouled back. It's 2-2 now. Here's the 2-2. It's fouled off down the left field side.
Shows pretty impressive bat control there for Watson. That one was halfway into the opposite batter's box. He just flips the bat out there and fouls it away.
Two balls and two strikes. They're going to call time at the plate.
Yeah, man, Buren's signals are lengthy. I think the indicator is the 12th signal that he gives out there.
We've played an inning and a third in an hour and 4 minutes as the first or the 2-2's out of bounds or out of play. Gotta say, it's probably the longest inning and a third that I've ever been a part of.
Yeah. There's a lot of crooked numbers on that board. Not a single zero in any column.
Nothing on the board is zero. Here's the 2-2. Swung on, lifted to right center field, and coming in to make a diving catch was Gage Watson for the second out, but it will bring in a run.
Great job there by Kai Henry to track that one down, but a run still comes across to score.
Yeah, I said Gage Watson. I meant Kai Henry. And boy, he was able to – you were right on the speed. He was able to get over and cover some ground quick.
Either way, the run does come home from third. Watson gets an RBI for the sack fly.
So now Peyton Voiles is at the plate. Voiles is the second baseman, and he walked back in the first and then struck out also in the first. He is the ninth batter here in the second inning.
Marion has sent 20 to the plate already through the first two innings, inning and two-thirds to be exact.
And there's strike one.
Now batting the catcher, number two, Peyton Voiles.
Now a throw back to first. You know, honestly, I think, Bobby, that's the least of his worries is the guy at first base.
They always want to make sure they don't just swipe an extra bag and go into scoring position, but now there's a big hole over on the right side with the left-handed batter up at the plate as they're holding that runner on.
Here's the 0-1. Tried to go with a drag bunt. Now they'll go throw down to third. He throws him out. He threw out Connor Brinkley. It goes 2-5 on the putout for the third out.
Both Brinkley and the Marion coach are a little befuddled by the call. They're trying to get an explanation.
So for Marion, they put up four runs in the second inning. They now have 11. It's 11-3 over Van Buren. You're watching the Centennial Bank State Baseball Championships on Arkansas PBS Sports.
Thanks, George. Appreciate it. At Big Red Stores, we're always proud to sponsor, support, and partner up with many events and activities throughout the community. Among them, high school championships throughout the state of Arkansas. At Big Red Stores, our team members are always ready to assist you to make your visit with us a pleasant one. And at Big Red Stores, we recognize that none of our support or ability to serve the community is possible without you. That's why at Big Red Stores, you're always the MVP of the Big Red team. Big Red Stores, now more convenient than ever. We never gonna stop.
You want to relive all the action from the first inning and a half of this game? You can do it next week. Just go to youtube.com/ArkansasPBS. Just make sure you've got an hour and 3 minutes to watch the first inning and a half because it's taking a while.
Yeah. I don't know if they're going to have enough hard drive space and memory on the YouTube channel for this one.
Have to bump up to the premium subscription for this.
Oh, it's 11-3. We're in the bottom of the second inning. Van Buren's going to be at the plate. They've got three runs off one hit. So far, Marion today, 11 runs off eight hits. And Kai Henry's going to be at the plate. And he got hit.
Second time the leadoff man for Van Buren's been on base. Walked in the first. Now drilled right between the shoulder blades. Start to second. That's what's wild is, you know, Marion's got an eight-run lead and Van Buren has the leadoff man starting the second inning as well.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, both of these teams are just putting runners on base for free just far too often.
But here's the other crazy thing. Armstrong came in the ball game with a one ERA. He was 3-1 with a one.
Yeah.
Well, Gattis came in with a 1.83 ERA.
Yeah, well, there's not many earned runs today.
Well, true.
All six of the seven in the first that Van Buren gave up from Gattis were unearned. All three in the first from Marion that they allowed were unearned.
But, I mean, when you see that, though, you think that they're going to have some control. I mean, there's a 1-0 that's called a strike to Presley Nichols.
So maybe what the uncharacteristic side of it is the defensive miscues.
Yeah, but, there's been three errors.
Yeah, but timely errors when you allow an extra runner or give a team a fourth out.
Yeah. Here's the 1-1.
That's kind of funny about this. You have to really dive into the weeds about baseball statistics. Is anything after an error, after two outs, everything is unearned.
Yeah.
So all three, even though Van Buren scored because of hits or walks or whatever the case may be, they were unearned because it happened after the third out should have been recorded.
Either way, though, I mean,
Tom Amansky taught me all that.
Yeah.
And him and his defensive drills tapes. They're sponsored by Fred McGriff, by the way.
I guess my point was that both these pitchers were really good coming in.
Yeah.
As 2-2 swung on, popped up on the infield. And he'll have to drift back. That being Brinkley, and he'll make the catch for the first out. Now Eli Gilruth is going to come to the plate. Gilruth fouled out down the first base line over in the first inning.
Now batting the pitcher, number 24, Eli Gilruth.
Fastball outside, misses. Connor Brady, the catcher's on deck. Here's the 1-0. That's swung on and missed.
Gilruth not cheated on that swing. He was trying to put one into the woods out in left field, trying to wake up Bigfoot.
One ball, one strike. Runner goes, it's fouled back.
For those of you who didn't watch the game last night, the 4A championship game, we established that Bigfoot lives out in those woods.
Well, there's a set of woods that are off the left field wall, and I contend that there's a lot of foul balls that just have found a home down there. You know, Benton High School is actually on the other side of those trees, but there's a nice gap of trees in between there.
Maybe that's where they keep the panther.
There's those trees we were talking about. I mean, it's thick.
But every high school has a live mascot, right? So they have to have a panther somewhere.
As the curveball is outside.
Van Buren has a pointer.
Is that a dog?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, I mean, Conway doesn't have a wampus cat.
Sure they do. Keep it in the new indoor facility.
Here's the 2-2. That swung on. Giving a ride to center field, and that is going to be out of here at 375. That is the second home run of the weekend, and by far the farthest spot in the ballpark.
That was touched, absolutely hammered by Gilreath. The wind started to pick up a little bit, but that one is absolutely hammered. It just got up into the jet stream, which is not supposed to exist here at Benton. We were talking with Coach Ballesteri. He might have said there might have been 15 home runs ever at this ballpark, and that one was a bomb over the cameras in center field.
Yeah, that left in a hurry. You know, when I first saw it, I was like, oh, it was a hard hit ball, but it's going to hit about the wall.
Yeah, it just kept carrying. That one clears it by plenty. If you parked out there beyond the center field wall, you might want to go check on your windshield.
Yeah. So it's now a six-run lead for Marion, and they're going to pull Armstrong. When they bring out the new pitcher, we'll take a break and get you all the info on him as you're watching the Centennial Bank State Baseball Championships in Arkansas PBS Sports.
Local broadcast of Arkansas PBS programming is made possible in part by Community Bakery. Scratch-made breads, pastries, cakes, treats, and locally roasted coffees served daily at two locations in Little Rock, 1200 Main and 270 Shackelford.
Hey, I'm Rick Steves. You know, I don't go anywhere without my passport. And now, thanks to PBS Passport, you can travel with me and watch all 10 seasons of Rick Steves Europe and all my travel specials. This exclusive streaming service is just for our members. Not only can you see all my shows, but you can see thousands of hours of your favorite public television shows. Become a member today and get your passport.
The Electric Cooperatives of Arkansas. Over 2,500 team members across 17 local electric distribution co-ops, powering homes, farms, and industries somewhere across Arkansas. We are the Electric Cooperatives of Arkansas. Power and people.
Well, the new pitcher for Marion is Benjamin Garrard, and he comes in with a 1.49 ERA with 84 strikeouts, 21 walks. He's only hit two batters this entire season. That might change today at the rate we're going, but either way, Benjamin Garrard is the new pitcher for Marion after the monster bomb that took place by Eli Gilreath. Here's a replay of the home run.
We were just talking during the break. This may be the longest home run we've ever seen here, hitting here.
And, I mean, he got great contact, and he just went right over that 375 marker. And, you know, I've seen a lot of baseball games here, and Coach Ballesteri as well, and not too many folks have gotten to that area of the ballpark.
Just when you thought this game was over, it's 7-0, 11-3. Pointer's not going away.
So Connor Brady now is at the plate. As we're in the bottom of the second inning.
Say that again.
We're at the bottom of the second as there's a strike on the outside. 0-1. Yeah, no, we've officially played an hour and 17 minutes. As that one's up top, it's 1-1. Want to say hello to our good friend Tim Terry up in Greenwood. He's watching today on the broadcast. And that swung on right back up at the box into the center field. It's cut off by the second baseman, but not before they ruled a hit.
Oh, double T. He's called a lot of state championship games in his day.
Well, you know, he's texting right now and says that Eli Gilreath who just hit the home run a little bit ago, is dating his niece.
Uh-oh.
So, I mean, he got pretty excited to see that home run.
I can think of a lot of people that I'd want to be related to someone I'm dating.
Yeah.
Tim Terry's pretty good people.
He's really good people.
That wouldn't be bad.
Jackson Rodert is up next. He's the first baseman for Van Buren. He walked back in the first inning.
I always remember to text him happy birthday every year, mainly because it's the same day as my birthday.
That helps. Yeah. The first pitch is up high. I mean, Tim is like the man of Greenwood. Like,
No doubt.
He's the voice of the Bulldogs for every sport. I think he's like mayor or city councilman or something like that. And so you need your tire changed, you call Tim. He goes and gets that done for you.
He's not mayor. You probably should vote for him.
But I think he is on the city council.
There's nothing the man can't do.
I mean, he is a man of many talents. Two balls, no strikes. I know the people that don't know Tim, they're wondering who we're talking about. As that pitch sails inside, it's 3-0. One out here in the bottom of the second inning. Benjamin Garrard took over here in the inning. Pitch is on the way, and it's low, and it's a walk.
Second straight inning, Jackson Rodert's earned a walk.
Bobby, you know, I was thinking back to what you said after Marion put up the seventh spot in the first, and you said, to quote you, there's a lot of baseball left to be played.
I didn't know there was a lot of baseball to be played for the next inning and a half.
You said, there's going to be a lot of baseball left to be played. It's 11-5.
Might want to clear your dinner plans.
Hayden Hurst at the plate. Runners at first and second. That swung on a miss. Boy, did you see the Razorback baseball score?
I saw they're down 18-3.
Yeah.
I kind of quit paying attention after that one.
Got a text that the nine-hole hitter hit a grand slam on him.
They're scuffling a little bit.
Here's the 0-1. Curveball out to second base. Going to try to roll it up. Got the out at second. Back to first. Twin killing. The 4-6-3 double play. And that's going to retire the side. So for Van Buren, they put up two runs in the inning on one base or two base hits. They strand one, and we head to the top of the third inning. It's 11-5 Marion. You're watching the Centennial Bank State Baseball Championships in Arkansas PBS Sports.
This month in Passport on the PBS video app.
I'm sorry.
Too late. She loves her job.
She loves you too. Introduce my dear friend, Miss Lamb.
Did I notice you smile? Certainly. Not.
Downton is catching up with the times we live in.
This calls for a toast.
These and other shows from Arkansas PBS are available with Passport on the PBS video app.
My name is Al Lopez, Papa Rat in the house. I live in Northwest Arkansas via Puerto Rico. Been here since 1994. Did the 94, and really, Arkansas PBS is the one that has taught me about this great community that we have here. Wonderful, beautiful, so much programming, tanta programación for children, for grown-ups, porque es el canal de Arkansas. This is the real Arkansas channel.
Get your live action photos from the game at myarpbs.org/photos. Grab a free download, you can have print made. These are great championship keepsakes.
A lot of action going on here in the 5A game. You know, we were talking about colleges earlier and who all is going for Marion, and we failed to mention the colleges that some of the Van Buren guys are going to. Looks like Gilruth's going to Missouri Southern, Brady Eastern Oklahoma, and then Gavis is going down to Hot Springs.
National Park.
National Park, yeah.
Yep, big shout out to Chad Frazier, hooking us up with some info. It's always nice to get texts from coaches from around the state who are watching the contest.
It's like we got a new pitcher in the ball game for Van Buren.
It's the catcher, Brady, moves to the mound.
Yeah, Brady will be up.
We'll see that. You can see right in the middle of his jersey there. He's stolen the safety pin back.
Safety pin is popular these days. Brady comes in with a 4.3 ERA as he's had 38 strikeouts, 17 walks. Worked 24 innings so far this year.
So
Connor Brady is on the mound.
Peyton Pashir now behind the plate, 23. Changes abound. So if you're keeping score at home, if you're filling out that scorebook and pen, soul, not pen.
Second baseman,
yeah,
two,
I messed that up.
I'm using a Sharpie, so yeah. I really screwed it up.
So Peyton Boyles is going to lead things off for Marion here in the top of the third inning. As the first pitch at 89 miles an hour is up top. Last ball catches the outside corner. It's one, or inside corner. It's 1-1. Another fastball for a strike. It's 1-2. It's the 2-3-4 hitters due up for Marion here in the inning. That swung on, popped up on the infield. Waters is going to come in and make the catch.
It took until the top of the third inning, but the leadoff hitter has been retired. Neither side have been able to retire the leadoff man until that point.
Now Dylan Kite comes to the plate. He had a single back in the second inning out to right field. He also struck out back in the first. This pitch is a ball. We've got 5A softball coming up next, right?
5A softball, the host school, the Benton Lady Panthers, trying to cap off a second straight perfect season. Taking on Greene County Tech, first pitch scheduled, key word there, for 7:05.
1-1's the count. Swung on, out to second base. And Gaddis has got it, throws it over for the 4-3 putout. Now that brings up Armstrong to the plate.
Now batting the third baseman, number 32, Chase Armstrong.
Armstrong today has had two singles. He had the big shot to center, and then he singled to left field last inning. Curve ball's up high. It's a 1-0, and this is low, and it's 2-0. Two balls, no strikes. That swung on. It's a high fly ball in the infield. Who's going to get it? Third baseman says he's got it. That's Dudley, and that's going to do it. It's a 1-2-3 third inning. Haven't been able to say that the entire game. We head to the bottom of the third, where Marion leads Van Buren 11-5. You're watching the Centennial Bank State Baseball Championships on Arkansas PBS Sports.
Sports is so important to this state and the fabric of the state, and I appreciate Arkansas PBS doing all the state title games, and that makes it available for not just the fans in Central Arkansas, South Arkansas, but fans around the entire state. I can only think of the kids in small towns, and this is the biggest moment maybe in their sports careers, and they have that keepsake of having that game on TV to have with them the rest of their lives.
For every moment, for every memory, from that first car to your first home, to your first child, and all the highs and lows that tomorrow might bring. For everything that matters most to you and your family, there's someone right around the corner dedicated to helping you protect what you love. Your local Farm Bureau insurance agent. Farm Bureau Insurance. Real service, real people.
Every year we recognize outstanding Arkansas student athletes who have made an impact in the classroom and out on the field. In the 5A division, we're highlighting Jake Jones as our student athlete. And remember, if you want to tweet Jake, just use that hashtag ARPBS Sports. We'll get a graphic up of Jake a little bit later on, but Jake is our 5A Division I scholar athlete. Well, we are back here in the bottom of the third inning. It's 11-5, Marion over Van Buren. And Brecken Waters comes to the plate for Van Buren. It's the 7-8-9 hitters. Waters got a base hit back in the first inning. And the first pitch is going to miss outside. It'll be 1-0.
Two RBI single back in the first for Waters.
There's the 2-0 pitch. Two balls, no strikes. And that misses outside. It's 3-0. You've got Waters, then you got Nowotny and Gaddis all due up this inning. Benjamin Garrard is on the mound for Marion as he delivers a strike on 3-0. Here's the 3-1 pitch. That's a chopper out to short. As Brinkley's going to throw it across for the first out. So now Joshua Nowotny's at the plate. He got hit by a pitch back in the first.
Now batting the right fielder, number four.
Water stumbled coming out of the box, but didn't matter. It's a nice strong throw there. And now Marion has finally retired the leadoff man.
Here's the first pitch, and that's a nice curveball in there for a strike.
61 on that bender.
No balls, one strike. Here's the pitch. Fastball at 87. Boy, you go from 87 to 61.
Yeah. Talk about having to speed the bat up or slow it down. You almost have no chance. If you're sitting curveball and that 87-mile-an-hour heater shows up, you're not catching up with it.
Here's the 0-2. And curveball got out of his hand a little bit. It's now 1-2. Ball, two strikes. That's going to miss inside, and now 2-2. Boy, all the scoring that took place early on. Marion scored 7 in the first inning, then 4 in the second. Van Buren answered with 3 in the first and 2 in the second. That swung on and missed for the second out. Now the 9-hole hitter, Devin Gaddis, is at the plate. He struck out back in the first inning.
Now batting the second baseman, number 42, Devin Gaddis.
Fastball misses high. Bobby, you're going to be on the call of the softball game coming up, right?
That's the word.
Here's the 1-0.
Yep, alongside Eric King, we'll have the call right here on Arkansas PBS.
What you're saying is if they start that, you're going to have to – I'm going to be going solo on this one. Cool.
We're going to go to the bullpen and make sure you're not left alone.
Here's the 1-1.
We know that you're not to be trusted alone. Someone needs to send in some supervision.
One ball, two strikes. Two outs here in the third.
The team players around here.
I think we'll be done by the time that softball game gets going. Here's the 1-2. It's up top. It's now 2-2.
I like the thought process. I do.
I mean, it's still an hour and a half away.
It is. That'll put us in about the fourth inning on the pace we're at. I can't.
Here's the 2-2. Curveball in there, strike three.
Nasty hook.
That is a good-looking curveball, and that's going to get us out of the third. 1-2-3. Go the pointers. We head to the top of the fourth inning where Marion leads it 11-5. You're watching the Centennial Bank State Baseball Championships on Arkansas PBS Sports.
Hey, I'm Rick Steves. You know, I don't go anywhere without my passport. Thanks to PBS Passport, you can watch all my travel specials. This exclusive streaming service is just for our members. Not only can you see all my shows, but you can see thousands of hours of your favorite public television shows. Become a member today.
The Electric Cooperatives of Arkansas. Over 2,500 team members across 17 local electric distribution co-ops, powering homes, farms, and industries somewhere across Arkansas. We are the Electric Cooperatives of Arkansas. Power and people.
Farmers and Merchants Bank and the Bank of Fayetteville share the mission of Arkansas PBS to enrich and empower all Arkansans. Community, dignity, respect. That's what me banking is all about. More at mebanking.com.
Let me take you for a ride on the baseline.
Let's go! Okay, I said last inning I want to recognize Jake Jones. There's Jake Jones from Benton High School. He's a pitcher, a third baseman, a junior with a 3.3 GPA. And he's going to our alma mater to play baseball, Central Arkansas. So I want to say congratulations to Jake Jones for being the 5A Division I Player of the Year, as chosen by us.
The University of Great Athletes. Oh, Central Arkansas, I mean.
That place, yes. So due up is Connor Taylor. He's the five-hole hitter. As he'll take a strike at 88. It's Taylor, Matthew Kearney, and Luke Bullens, the hitters in this go-round. 0-1 is another fastball for a strike. O-2's the count. Pitch by Brady, and it's a chopper out to second. And there to make the catch, and the toss over to first was Geddes. That's now one out now here in the top of the fourth.
I think the nerves have settled down. The excitement level of the ballpark has settled down. These two teams are now going to get locked in and try to battle it out. Of course, Marion got a six-run lead.
So now Gerard is at the plate. It'll be his first plate appearance today. Well, look at a curveball, and it'll be a strike. Here's the 0-1. Fastball misses low, and it's 1-1.
It's a pretty impressive crowd for a Saturday afternoon with weather threatening.
1-1, curveball, calling a strike, and it's 1-2.
I was a little worried that the threat of weather might keep some of these fans away, but Certainly has not been the story.
A little rain never hurt nobody.
Van Buren to here's easily 2 hours, maybe a little farther.
1-2's fouled back in the net.
And Marion's got to be equal distance, if not
out there by Jonesboro.
Yeah, touch farther.
Yeah.
These two covered a football game 2 years ago. These two played each other in the playoffs.
Here's the 1-2 pitch. That's fouled back. Top of the fourth inning, where Marion leads right now 11-5. One, two is popped up over into foul territory, giving chase is the first baseman, and he didn't make the catch. He had it hit his glove, and it just fell out.
A long, long run over there for Rodert. Thought he might make the over-the-shoulder catch, just couldn't corral it.
But still 1-2. Curveball misses high. It's now 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Is want to get clarification on the mound. Fastball gets away from the catcher and takes the count to 3-2. Here's the full count offering, and that swung on, driven into center field. Going back to the warning track, and it's caught right there. Garrard tried to give it a run, and it was hauled in by Kai Henry, and now that brings up Luke Bullins.
Brady's retired the five hitters he's faced. That's coming in to pitch.
First pitch to Bullins. That swung on and missed.
90 on the radar gun.
Had some hard throwers in this game.
Are the radar guns feeling the temperatures? Or Brady's got a cannon attached to that right shoulder.
Here's the 0-1 at 90 again. That's hit out to third. Dudley will make the throw and complete the inning. 5-3 on the putout. And so we now head to the bottom of the fourth inning, where we've got an 11-5 game. You're watching the Centennial Bank State Baseball Championships on Arkansas PBS Sports.
Well over 2,000 Arkansas rice farms. 96% of them are family owned and operated.
It's all about building community.
The results we've been seeing have been very promising.
I grew up watching the farm, knowing every detail about it.
If you take care of the soil will take care of you.
It helps us to give back to the land and make sure that it's going to be there for future generations.
Every community has a story to tell, and if somebody will tell it, it'll be interesting.
You know, I think sports are really big to a lot of people, and because it's an important part of our fabric and our community. And the one good thing about what I've seen is it's high quality production. You know, you think of the small communities all over Arkansas, it's a big deal that they can turn on the TV or DVR or whatever and know they're gonna get a quality product. And so I think it just expands the focus of what PBS is doing. You know, Arkansas PBS is doing a great job, and I think it's part of education.
Celebrate game day under the arches. Access tons of benefits through our rewards program, and it's available today on the McDonald's app. We're loving it.
We are in the bottom of the fourth inning, where for Van Buren, they're going to send their 1-2-3 hitters to the plate. Kai Henry, Presley Nichols, and Eli Gilruth. And back on the mound for Marion will be Benjamin Garrard. Kai Henry today has been walked once, then he got hit by a pitch. And so we're just about setting ready to go as pitcher and catcher, they get their instructions and they're ready to roll.
Leading off for the Pointers.
I think the most impressive thing, Van Buren's only got three hits in this game.
Yeah.
Five runs, three hits.
They've been patient at the plate, and they picked up a handful of walks, been hit by a pitch.
Curveball's in there for a ball.
And Kai Henry's been on the pass both times. He stepped to the plate, scored both times as well. Doing exactly what a leadoff man is supposed to do.
1-0 is a fastball in there for a strike. 1-1.
If you would have asked the Van Buren coaching staff, okay, Kai Henry's coming up to lead off the fourth, and it's his third at bat, they take that every time.
Yeah. One one's down in the turf. Takes the count to 2-1.
All five runs scored for Van Buren have been scored by the top half of their lineup.
2-1. That's swung on and fouled out of play. Honestly, I think that's the first time that we've seen Henry actually make contact with the ball.
They haven't tasked him to do a whole lot as far as the Marion pitchers. Walked him in the first, hit him right in the back in the second.
So two balls, two strikes. As that pitch is low to take things full.
Good patience, good eye as a leadoff man. It's exactly what you want. I mentioned the 15 stolen bases. Just got to find a way to get on, create some havoc on the path.
3-2. That bounces to the plate. And Kai Henry once again is on the bags with another walk. So now Presley Nichols, the left fielder, steps in. He got on the bags back in the first inning because of a throwing error by the second baseman. In the second, he lined out to the shortstop.
Kai Henry's now drawn 28 walks on the season. That's second most on the team. On base percentage, close to .500. He's staying true to the numbers.
Curveball to him is a ball. Here's the 1-0 pitch as it's going to catch the outside corner for 1-1. On deck is Eli Gilruth. Runner goes. It's a ball, and he'll slide in safe.
Well, that's almost, it looked like a little bit of a delayed steal by Kai Henry. Didn't really take off right as first movement from Garrard. Able to swipe second base easily. Stolen base number 16 on the season.
So that takes the count to 2-1 at the plate. I was talking to the Benton baseball coach last night, and I asked him, do you have to work on base sliding, you know, practice? He said, oh, yeah. He said, we dedicate about an hour to every day to sliding on the turf.
I remember the first time we saw championship games played on turf. And I want to say it was at UCA that the games got moved there because they were, it rained in Fayetteville. And routinely, teams were sliding over the bases. And then finally, later on, that they went out there and started practicing, sliding into to second and to third just because they ran themselves into a couple extra outs or saw other teams do so.
Here's the 2-2. Curveball misses outside.
There's a good shot at the synthetic grass. That is not dirt.
No. And it's not chalk either.
Nope.
We learned that in the softball game today.
What's really interesting, and most people won't understand, and I'm not sure if it's like this, there's a lot of parks that the plate is actually just painted turf as well.
Yeah, that's right. That's swung on and fouled off. No. And I think UCA actually used to have, I think they've now got a real plate, but at when they first got theirs, I want to say that they had a painted plate.
Yeah.
And it was always funny because when the umpire would go, he'd pause it and he'd go sweep the plate, and you're like, what are you doing, man?
Yep. It's just habit. It's like, especially, you know, if a catcher walks out to talk to his pitchers, like, you got to do something to kill time, and all of a sudden you realize, well, I can't really swipe that off. There's a good look at that. That is a real plate here at Benton. The lip of the turf around it.
See that? Now that plate needs to be dusted off. It's got too many rubber pellets on it.
It's amazing how you think this is the playing surface changes how a game is played.
Yeah,
it really does.
Three balls, two strikes. That swung on and lifted to the left. Going back is Bullens, and he'll make the catch, and Kai Henry is going to advance to third base.
That's called trusting your speed there by Henry. Well, not many players will try to tag from second to third on a fly ball to left field. But he slides in head first, well ahead of the throw. Gets himself to third with just one out, and that's huge because, of course, the pass ball or wild pitch, he can score and chip into this Patriot lead.
Eli Gilchrist at the plate. He had that monster home run back in the second inning. Out to dead center field. What do you think that ball went? 385?
Easy.
Yeah.
It's kind of hard to tell how much it cleared the fence by.
That ball's in the turf for a 1-0 count.
Just one of those fly balls that just continued to carry, and the wind wasn't really helping it that much. It would have been a home run in pretty much every high school park in the state. A lot of college parks, too.
I was going to say, that'd been a home run at Dickie Stevens Park. Here's the 1-0. Well, I guess now it's 400 dead center.
Yeah, it might have got there, though, to be honest, as high as it was.
2-0's the count.
It's the old line from Major League. It's too high. No, it's too far.
Huh?
The home run ball in the movie Major League.
Oh, yes, I'm sorry.
Oh,
yes.
It's too high.
Yeah. Here's the 2-0 that's fouled back. You know, I am not good at movie lines. Yeah. Like, I think the only one I'm really good at is like, hey, Dad, have a catch. You know that one?
Well, that sounds like a serious movie. I'm more of a comedy guy.
It's the one with the cornfield.
Field of Dreams.
Yeah. It's the most iconic line in the movie.
Guess.
Here's the 2-1 as it misses outside.
And I mean, you got to go into full character. If you're going to quote a movie line, you've got to literally get into character and say it with the voice and the inflection.
He said, hey, Dad, have a catch.
It's better. Good for you.
Look, I am terrible at movie lines, and I finally remember one, and I have to go into character for it.
You referenced Star Wars earlier this week.
3-1.
So there's that.
I did. Yes, I did. It's full count. 3-2. Best baseball movie of all time for you?
The Natural, probably.
Yeah, I'm a big Natural fan. Here's the 3-2 pitch. That swung on, lifted out to right center field. That'll get in the power alley, and Henry will come in to score. Rounding first is Gilchrist. He's going to hold up at second base.
Gilchrist done plenty of damage at the plate. Two-run homer back in the second. RBI double here in the fourth. Van Buren staying alive, chipping away.
He now has three RBI today. It's now a five-run lead. And Connor Brady comes to the plate. He had a single back in the second inning.
Now batting the catcher, number 8, Connor Brady.
You know, the way this game started, you thought, boy, this is going to get out of hand quick. And you look up there now, Bob, and five runs are, I mean, that's nothing to.
That's nothing.
Yeah.
Exactly right. Marion led it 7-0, then 11-3.
Curveball that misses. One ball, no strikes. That swung on and popped up out of play. Jason Rodert's on deck. Only one out here in the bottom of the fourth inning.
Five pitches now thrown for Garrard.
And that one swung on, popped up on the backside of the infield on the shortstop side. And coming over to make the catch was Brinkley. So there's two outs now in the inning as Jackson Roberts come, or Roberts come, comes to the plate.
Now Roberts walked both of his trips to the plate
Jackson
today.
Roberts.
Walked and scored in the first. Walked and part of a double play in the second.
Here's the pitch to Roberts. It's a curve ball, called a strike. Ball in there, 94. It's 0-2.
Right at the knees, really nice pitch there. Gets ahead in the count, 0-2. And now Rodert, who hasn't been forced to swing the bat yet today because of those two walks, gonna have to shorten up and try to put one in play.
Here's the 0-2 pitch, curveball. Back out to the shortstop. Brinkley's got it. He throws it over, 6-3 on the putout. So that's going to do it for Van Buren here in the bottom of the fourth inning. They do score one run. They got a base hit. They strand one runner. We head to the top of the fifth inning. It's 11-6. Marion leads it. You're watching the Centennial Bank State Baseball Championships on Arkansas PBS Sports.
Can you see her greatness? When you attend her games, when you cheer her on, or when you participate in any way, you support your community and make it better, and you will see her greatness. Join us as we pledge to increase the visibility of women's sports in our communities. It makes a difference when we all are involved. At Everett Butte GMC, we proudly support our local female athletes and encourage you to do the same. See her greatness.
This month on Arkansas PBS.
Come explore Columbia, wild and free.
Discovering the secret life of bees took me on a journey I was not expecting.
Take a closer look at this miracle of nature.
Actually, scaly skin.
Dinosaur apocalypse.
Can newly uncovered footage offer clues?
Well, I've never seen it.
Only on Arkansas PBS.
You want a copy of today's broadcast? All you've got to do is go to mmproductions.net, place your order, get yourself a digital video disc copy of this. and watch it from now until the end of time.
That guy has gotten more TV time today because of Bobby.
Hey, you got to do what you have to do to get your fame. If you wear something like that, I will point it out.
Well, so Marion's at the plate today. The 8-9-1 hitters are due up for Marion. Connor Brinkley's going to lead things off. And Connor Brady's back on the mound for Van Buren. First pitch is a ball. We're in the top of the fifth inning. So this game is officially 2 hours old at this point. As the second pitch is a strike to make it 1-1. It's not too bad, I guess, the way this one started. Be two hours old and you're in the top of the fifth. 1-1's fouled out of play. Here's the 1-2 offering. That'll be low and inside to even the count at two apiece.
Send a quick congratulations to the Bentonville West Lady Wolverines, Conway Wampus Cats. They both claimed 6A soccer championships today here at the Benton Athletic Complex.
Here's the 2-2, and it's fouled back. You know, we should look and get like Carlos Chicas to call those games one year.
Yeah, they're on the National Federation of High Schools streams.
Oh, yeah, they're on the stream.
Yeah.
Carlos does a good job with soccer. Here's the 2-2. That's swung on, ripped out to second. Gaddis is right there. He'll throw it over for the first out.
You have to give a tip of the cap to the way Connor Brady has pitched since he came in the third. He's retired all seven batters he's faced. Just came in and thrown strikes. Does not have a strikeout. Just trusting his defense to make plays, forcing Marion to put it into play. Good things are happening for the pointer pitcher.
Now Caleb Katt's going to be at the plate. Katt today got a triple back in the first inning, then walked in the second. And a bunt right back at the pitcher, and he slipped. He'll throw, and he's safe. He got a bare hand on the ball, kind of bobbled it briefly. I think that was just enough to not get the out.
Yep, nice job by Katt to force pressure on the defense and bunted a little too hard right back at the pitcher, but you see there a little bit of slip, didn't handle it cleanly, and he does clearly beat the throw at first.
So now back to the top of the lineup as Gage Watson comes up. Had a base hit back in the first inning. He also got on because of an error in the first inning and then lined out to center field in the second. First pitch to him, it's a fastball, called a strike. Third, first base. Here's the 0-1. That's up high and tight, a little chin music. I'd say Brady is really concerned with the runner at first. He's paid him a lot of attention as Watson's been at the plate. As that swung on, lifted out to center field. Giving chase is Henry, and he'll make the catch. So now Peyton Voiles will come to the plate. Voiles walked back in the first inning, then struck out in the first. And popped up to the shortstop in the third.
Now batting the second baseman, number two, Peyton Voiles.
Now goes. He'll throw down to second, and it was off the mark, and it'll be a stolen base.
Nice heads-up base running there by Cat. Put the pressure on the Van Buren defense. We've had to see the pointers move players around already on the infield, and the throw from Bashir kind of went to nobody. Nobody got to the bag in time.
So two outs here in the fifth inning. It's a 1-0 count to Boyles. Dylan Kites on deck. Talked about it earlier. Boyles is going to be headed to Graceland College. Here's the 1-0 driven into center field. Kai Henry's right there at the line drive to him, and that's going to retire the side. So for Marion, they got one base hit. They strand a runner, no runs. We head to the bottom of the fifth inning, where Marion leads it 11-6. You're watching the Centennial Bank State Baseball Championships on Arkansas PBS Sports.
I think it's important for Arkansas PBS to have sports because it provides sports on a greater platform to the entire community. And it also gives people in various other communities an opportunity to see other schools and other athletes and to have a greater appreciation for not just their own community, but the sports that are available across the state of Arkansas. There are so many lessons that sports provides, and it's one of the reasons why it's so important to the next generation of athletes coming up.
Since 1976, McCormick Equipment Rental and Sales has been equipping Arkansans for the tough jobs, construction equipment and rentals, service and sales, and a proud underwriter of Arkansas PBS Sports.
The Electric Cooperatives of Arkansas. Over 2,500 team members across 17 local electric distribution co-ops, powering homes, farms, and industries somewhere across Arkansas. We are the Electric Cooperatives of Arkansas. Power and people.
You love watching the state finals on Arkansas PBS? Just text sports to 501-491-0444 to donate $10 to Arkansas PBS Sports.
Those guys have to be hot underneath that tent.
No doubt.
I mean, and reason they're not dressing up for Halloween or anything, we were literally supposed to get rain today, and we've not had it. In fact, looked at the radar a moment ago, and I think we may get lucky, and it may not even hit us at all.
Well, if you have any wood around you, but knock on it, please.
So the Van Buren pointers are at the plate here in the fifth inning. And they'll send their 6-7-8 hitters to the plate. Hayden Hurst, Brecken Waters, and Joshua Nowotny. Hurst sees the curveball in there for a strike.
It's a 50th pitch by Garrard as he's coming in relief.
There's a fastball that misses outside, and it's now 1-1. Seen some hard hit balls today, that's for sure. As the 1-1 is tap fouled on the right field side, now 1-2. By the way, you found out where Graceland College is.
Did. The Google machine tells me it's Lamoni, Iowa.
So not anywhere close to where we were thinking. One ball, two strikes. And that's a fastball that misses inside. It's now 2-2. Just underway here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Here's a 2-2. Curveball hits the turf. 5-run lead for Marion.
Hurst. And an RBI walk back in the first. Those free RBIs are the best kind.
3-2's on the way. That's chopped out to third. Dudley's got it. Excuse me, not Dudley. That's actually Kearney's got it. And they get the first down here in the fifth. So now Brecken Waters comes up. Waters got a single back in the first inning to left field.
The shortstop, number three.
They grounded out to the shortstop back in the third. There's a fastball at 85 on the outside corner. It's 0-1.
Talk about how much the new pitcher for Van Buren, Connor Brady, has settled down. Garrard's done the exact same thing for Marion.
Curveball that's in front of the plate, 1-1. So is soccer done for today?
Soccer is done for today.
For the year?
Yeah, they are done for the year.
Yeah.
Eight championships handed out over the last 2 days.
A lot of championships.
Four on the boys' side, four on the girls'.
1-1 fastball misses outside. It's now 2-1.
Fewer classifications in soccer, of course, because fewer schools in the state play.
How many classifications are there in soccer?
Four.
Four?
Mm-hmm. 6-5, 4, and 3-8.
2-1. Outside, 3-1.
It's very similar to volleyball.
Yeah.
Fewer classifications because fewer teams playing.
Here's the 3-1 pitch. That's swung on out to short. And Brinkley will pick it up, and it's a bad throw. He'll be on the bags, and he'll get on because of a throwing error of the shortstop.
He tried to make the big wide turn, but slips. He's had to scamper back to the bag. Stays at first, but VB has a runner on.
So that'll bring up Joshua Nowotny. Nowotny got hit by a pitch back in the first and then struck out in the third.
Josh Nowotny.
First pitch to him is a curveball for a strike. Nowotny is the number 8 hitter in the lineup. Here's the 0-1. Fastball misses outside. 1-1.
I think we've hit the middle inning lull. The fans are getting restless.
Well, we kind of hit that in the first.
That's true.
And it's just had peaks and valleys since that point.
Well, Marion fans have been baking in the sun for a few hours now.
Here's the 1-1. That is a fastball that misses inside. It's now 2-1. Yeah, if you're the visiting team and you've got the evening game or the 4 o'clock game, it's not a great spot to sit.
Yeah. You're in a tough spot.
Yeah,
the home fans are in the shade. Softball, you're not protected at any point in the game. You're just baking in the sun.
Here's the 2-1. Fastball misses outside. It's now 3-1. You know, I was looking around a little bit ago before the game, and they've actually got locker rooms inside those dugouts here at the ballpark. So you can actually walk in. There's a locker room back on the backside. There's a door that goes back there. Here's the 3-1. It's up high. It's a walk. So that'll put Waters at second base. And Nowotny at first with his second time on the bags.
Just trying to continue to keep pressure on. Van Buren is only four hits today, but they've got the 6 runs.
Devin Gattis.
Finding the strike zone has been a constant struggle for the Patriot pitching staff.
So Gattis has struck out twice today.
7 base on balls issued by these Marion pitchers.
Gattis showed bunt but pulled it back after it was too high. we've got time called, and just going to slow things down a little bit more here in the fifth. They get in the groove.
17 runs, 13 hits, 4 errors combined between these two squads through the first 4.5 innings.
Yeah. Here's the 1-0, calling a strike on the outside.
That's a busy week, let alone half of a game.
That's a couple games right there. But Van Buren has slowly tried to claw their way back into it. The only inning they haven't scored in was the third. Here's the 1-1. That swung on and missed. It's 1-2.
Gaddis saw that one up around the eyes, thought it was a beach ball. Swung right underneath it.
Here's the 1-2 pitch. Curveball, got him. There's two outs now here in the fifth.
That is 0 for 3 with 3 strikeouts. Certainly a game he won't want to think about anytime soon.
I don't know if he'll go back to that YouTube channel and watch this one. So now Kai Henry comes up. Kai Henry has scored 3 times today. And he's walked twice and got hit by a pitch once.
That's the first time he hasn't let off an inning.
First pitch is a called fastball inside half the plate. One swung on and fouled off. No balls, 2 strikes. Got 2 outs here in the fifth inning. Curveball's left high, and it's now 1-2.
Look, this is a big spot for Van Buren. Trailing by 5. There's 7 outs remaining, potentially in their season. I can see them scratch one across here.
Here's the 1-2 pitch. Curveball back up into center field. And that's going to try to score a run. Here comes the throw. It's way over the catcher, but now retreating back to third base was Waters. And so Van Buren will have runners at second and third.
Kai Henry just continues to find ways to get on base. Single back up the middle. But they slam the brakes on at the end as
now batting the left fielder number
Brecken Waters.
So you've got, I said second and third, you've got bases loaded with Kai Henry over at first base.
That's a good look at the throw in from the outfield. And of course, the runner would have scored had they sent him, but they thought better of it.
Well, he was thinking about it, and he got about halfway down and turned around and came on back. So Presley Nichols, the left fielder, is up now. Nichols has 2 home runs on the year, but today he's 0 for 2 with getting on with an error, and that is found out of play.
Have to take advantage of the opportunities that you're given, RJ, and this is a big chance for Van Buren. An error, a walk, and a single. Have the bases loaded here in the bottom of the fifth. Down 5. Single to the outfield would score a couple, you think, that give Van Buren the life and chances they need in the later innings.
Here's So it's 0-1. Pass ball gets past the catcher. And when Waters at third base, he hesitated.
Yeah, just didn't see it sneak through the wickets. If you hesitate, you're better off staying put.
Well, and I think that Luke Weatherford was not happy with him because he was expecting him to go.
Yeah, but it's tough. Sometimes it's tough. You see the baseball get lost between the legs and just squirts out from behind. Should have been a run for Van Buren.
1-1. Call a strike on the outside corner. 1-2. Here's the 1-2 curveball, and there's strike three. He got out of it with a bases loaded situation. Unscathed, no runs given up. One base hit. We head to the top of the sixth inning where Marion leads it 11-6. You're watching the Centennial Bank State Baseball and Softball Championships on Arkansas PBS Sports.
Centennial Bank is committed to you. Since our founding in 1999, we've become one of the nation's most trusted banks by remembering that you come first, by empowering our communities to reach their highest potential through our dedication to local charities, education, and exceptional service, because we are proud to call Arkansas home. Banking with you in mind, Centennial Bank, member FDIC.
Had a lot of action in this ball game, and it was started in the first inning where Marion put up 7 runs in the first inning, and they just kept coming home. Look at those smiles all the way around. And then Van Buren said, you know what, we want to add some runs. So they added 3 in the bottom of the first inning where it was 7-3. Then comes the second inning. This one, all the fun happened because Gilruth got on top of one and sent over the 375-foot wall. And we go to the top of the sixth inning where it's 11-6. And leading things off for Marion is going to be Dylan Kite. First pitch to him sails high, and it's 1-0. You've got your 3-4-5 hitters due up for Marion. Kite on the day is struck out and grounded at the second baseman, but he did get a base hit in the second.
Look at Coach Weatherford, his first season as the head coach last year for Van Buren, led them to a state championship, trying to repeat.
Now changed out balls, I guess.
Weatherford went to, excuse me, Brady went to the rosin bag. It's warm out there on the playing surface.
Here's the 1-0. Swung on and fouled off. One, bound back again. Yeah. Those are kind of defensive swings, really. Here's the 1-2 pitch. That's outside, 2-2.
Brady's being aggressive. That one at 87 miles an hour. Working in and out of the zone. You mentioned the defensive swings. Brady's been really aggressive about coming on the inner third.
Here's the 2-2, swung on and missed. 85 mile an hour fastball.
Now batting, the third baseman, number 32, Chase Armstrong.
So now Chase Armstrong comes to the plate. Had two singles in the first and second innings, then popped up to the third baseman in the third. He's going to pop up on the right side here. That one is going to be right in front of the Marion dugout, and it'll be caught. So two quick outs here in the sixth as Connor Taylor comes to the plate.
Now batting, the first baseman, number 11, Connor Taylor.
First pitch to Taylor, is that the knee, is calling a strike. No balls, one strike. Curveball misses. On deck is Benjamin Garrard.
45 pitches thrown for Brady. This is his fourth inning of work.
1-1. Fastball misses outside. Here's the 2-1 pitch. That fastball is going to miss inside now. That swung on right back up by the pitcher's face, and it'll go back into center field.
Brady thought he was out of danger when he moved from catcher to pitcher, but that one just buzzes in the tower. Taylor smokes one in the center. His second hit. Sorry,
yeah.
RJ.
No, you're fine. So now Benjamin Garrard comes up. He flies to center field back in the fourth inning.
At least Tom Cruise asked to buzz the tower.
Yeah. Which, by the way, you know that comes out this week.
Yeah.
Comes out on Tuesday, the new Top Gun.
The sequel we never knew we didn't need.
Yeah. I am kind of excited about it.
Yeah, I guess. I mean, I'll watch it, but I don't know if I'm excited about it.
I think it's going to be a great movie.
They're going to remake Take My Breath Away?
Well, they are. I did see that they're going to have a volleyball scene.
Ha.
That comes out on Tuesday. So runner at first base as Garrard's in. 0-1 on the day. As the first pitch is called a strike.
Pinch runner number 17, Tyler Carey.
Here's the 0-1. It's now 0-2. Pumping the fastball. Same spot.
It's right on the black at 83. And from the camera angle, you might think, okay, that's off the plates. But you got to remember the camera angle is a little offset. It's not directly behind the pitcher. So something that catches the edge may appear on your screen to look a little too far outside.
Here's the 0-2. It's up high.
Tricks of television. That's how that works.
I mean, looking from center, you can see that's a little off center. Just a touch. I'm telling you what, those two guys that are out there on those cameras at center field, they have been there all weekend long. Just hanging out there on the scaffolding, just waving at folks. There they are. Doing a good job. They're right. You know what? They were right beside where that home run went out. It was just to the right of them. High in the sky.
Connor Brady looks a little frustrated. Had a conversation with the umpiring crew.
One ball, two strikes. Swung on and fouled off. Runner at first base for Marion. There's two outs here in the sixth. That swung on and fouled out of play. You said your next game starts at 7, right?
Allegedly.
And I said you were going to make it, but I'm starting to think you might not.
Going to have to tag out, likely after this half inning. Benton and Green County Tech need me.
Here's the 1-2, swung on and missed. And so that's going to do it for the top of the sixth inning. We head to the bottom of the sixth, where Marion leads it 11-6 over Van Buren. You're watching the Centennial Bank State Baseball Championships in Arkansas PBS.
Do you think that's the key thing missing in the conversation about climate change?
Learn a lot about the African American experience.
It's your palate, it's your taste, it's how you like to cook.
Look at all the colors.
Discovering stories of people.
Voices will be heard today.
People really see the message.
Such a shared experience.
The choice is yours.
You make the decision.
With Passport on the PBS video app.
Thanks, George. Appreciate it. At Big Red Stores, we're always proud to sponsor, support, and partner up with many events and activities throughout the community. Among them, high school championships throughout the state of Arkansas. At Big Red Stores, our team members are always ready to assist you to make your visit with us a pleasant one. And at Big Red Stores, we recognize that none of our support or ability to serve the community is possible without you. That's why at Big Red Stores, you're always the MVP of the Big Red team. Big Red Stores, now more convenient than ever.
We never gonna stop. We never gonna stop.
Learn more about the issues that impact our state with our long-running public affairs program, Arkansas Week. Fridays at 7:30 p.m. and Sundays at 10 a.m. right here on Arkansas PBS.
Well, that's a new voice. Much like we've had a bunch of pitching changes in the game, we had to go to the bullpen and get Bobby out of here, and Bobby had to go do softball. And we bring in Derek Walter now. And what's up, Derek?
Well, I am, I think, your 86th partner this week, I'm glad to be here.
Yeah, no, hey, I'm enjoying it. We've had a lot of folks roll through here this weekend, and in fact, our first batter up is going to be Eli Gilreth, who takes a first pitch strike, and he's had a heck of a day. Had a double, had a home run, three RBIs so far, as he'll chop one over the third base side. It'll go foul. No, you're right, though. We've had a lot of folks sitting in that chair this weekend, and Bobby's doing the play-by-play on the softball game that they're going to carry that live to tape, so that's why he had to leave to go do that ball game. Didn't think this game would lead up right to softball.
I asked him about 45 minutes ago. Wait for this pitch.
Here's the curveball, swung on and missed. There's one out here in the sixth.
I asked him, I said, do I need to start preparing for softball? And he said, why don't you just take over for me here? And I said, that's probably a good idea, because you got to prepare a lot. And I thought, I've got a lot of homework to do if I'm going to do the softball game.
Well, and here's the thing. Like, he may have missed like half the game over there in softball the way we've gone with this one.
It very well might.
We had an hour-long first inning.
So I had to walk across the facility here, And I was gone for a long time.
Here's a drive into left field and a diving attempt by the left fielder from Marion. That was Bowens, and it'll go all the way to the wall. It'll be a double by Connor Brady.
Great effort there by Bowens to try to make the play. Unfortunately, just out of his reach. And Van Buren going to have something going here with a double.
Only down by five. You know, you think that you see a five-run lead, you're like, oh, that's a lot of runs. But in this game, it's really not.
No, I, like I said, I walked up in the bottom of the first. I thought, my gosh, it's 7-0. And then I thought, it must have been the third or fourth inning. It was the first.
Yeah, it was still the first, Jim. Jackson Rodert's going to be at the plate with a runner at second. By the way, if you didn't notice, the reason why Connor Brady didn't make it all the way to third after hitting that one to the wall, he fell down going around first base. And so now a pinch runner is going to come in for him.
Courtesy runner for the catcher.
Looks like running will be Caleb Adams. But here's the replay. As he was rounding first, he got tripped up and just slid and then just kind of jogged it into second base.
That base just kind of took him out.
I think it was the turf monster that actually got him right before he got to the base. So now Rodert's going to be in with a runner at second. Here's the pitch. It's driven into center field. They're going to hold him up at third. That's a big throw, and they're going to have runners at second and third. And I know Coach Weatherford is wondering, why didn't you send him? And I think, honestly, you're trying to get as many runs as possible, and they knew how big of an arm the center fielder had.
Yeah, and that's Adams who came in to run for the pitcher there. He's now at third. But you're right. Now that's the second inning in a row for Van Buren. Well, he probably could have sent him, and they would have scored.
Yeah.
And I get, you know, the fact that you don't want to get out at home, but right now you're getting short on outs.
That's
you
right.
really need runs. And so at this point, I do think you got to start looking to send these guys and hopefully cut this deficit.
So now Hayden Hurst is in, walked back in the first, and he grounded out to short in the third baseman earlier. Here's a curveball that misses. It's 1-0. Down by five is Van Buren. One-0 pitch is outside. It's now 2-0.
85 pitches for Gerard. Can pitch 110 in a day.
You know, and yesterday we saw two pitchers in one game almost get to that 110 mark. Last night's affair. Here's the 2-0, and that's a fastball pumped in there for a strike. It's 2-1.
I think the first game of the tournament, he ended at 110.
Yeah, 110, yeah.
Yeah. Complete game.
Yeah. Got the win.
It's a lot of pitches.
It's a lot of pitches. You're exactly right. So far today, Van Buren's scored 6 runs on 7 hits. Here's the 2-1. That's up high. It's now 3-1.
Van Buren, 7 of 24 on the day, as a team batting .292, 6 walks and 6 strikeouts. To Marion's 10 of 27, which is .370.
Here's the 3-1 pitch. Fastball in there, called a strike. Boy, he thought it was a ball. Ball, and he was headed down to first. Now he got a full count.
Boy, that's not good. When it's a 3-2 count now, and you kind of showed the umpire up there by throwing your bat. I get it.
It was close.
It was close. Yeah. No, it was. But I hope you don't have a close pitch now because they don't take kindly to the bat flip on your way down to first.
3-2's the count. Here it comes. That swung on, popped up on the infield. Coming over is the third baseman Kearney, and he'll make the catch for the second out.
It's a big out right there for Marion. 2 outs now. Van Buren down to 1 here in the sixth. And obviously, you're in the sixth inning. You got to have runs. You're down 11-6. We talked about setting those runners. Potentially would have been 8-11. As we see that strike, it was low in the zone.
I mean, it was close enough. It could have been a strike or a ball. And
give Dylan Knight credit, though. He's a great frame there by the catcher.
Yeah, and usually if you're the batter, you just pause for a second before you do the bat flip. Now here's Brecken Waters, the shortstop. He had a single back in the first inning. That one hits the turf. Joshua Nawati's on deck. That swung, and it's right into the glove of a jumping shortstop, Brinkley, and that'll do it for the inning. Line out to Brinkley, and that's going to do it. They sent five batters to the plate. We head to the seventh. You're watching the Centennial Bank State Baseball and Softball Championships in Arkansas PBS.
The Arkansas Citizens Access Network gives you a front row seat to your state government. Live stream board and commission meetings, press conferences, legislative proceedings, and more. Events are also archived for 30 days. Receive updates right on your phone by texting ARCAN to 313131. Be informed and get involved at myarkansaspbs.org/ARCAN.
Join the baseball and softball conversation on social media with hashtag ARPBSSports.
I've used that a couple times this weekend when I've texted or when I've sent pictures about my broadcast partners. I've sent out about 10 of them. I mean,
are you out of text messages yet?
Here's the deal. I've done these championships now for 4 years between football, basketball, and baseball, and I've usually had one or two broadcast partners in that entire time. I've had more broadcast partners this one week than I have in the last 4 years.
Which, by the way, it's been a fun 4 years.
It has, brother. For those that don't know, Derek, who's with the Arkansas Activities Association, is going on to work on some of his own companies, and he will be leaving after the championship's over, and Bobby's going to be taking over for you. But if it weren't for Derek, Arkansas PBS and that whole partnership would have never happened.
Well, let's give credit where credit's due, and that's Tanisha Joe Conway as well.
Well, and you're exactly right on that, as Bowens is at the plate with a 1-0 count. But, no, I mean, between you and Tanisha and
yourself,
Ed, and everybody that got involved to bring these games to everybody across the state, a large amount of people need to say thank you for all the work that's been done. And look, you've left things in a lot better shape than you and some others have had, and you're going to be missed, buddy, but I know you'll still be around.
Oh, yeah, we'll come around. And I tell you, what's so cool about this partnership is that something that, I didn't come from a sports writing background, and so when I was over media relations, I looked at it, how can I help these student-athletes? It'll be the biggest game probably they ever play in, most of them.
Yeah.
How can we make it a big event, big time? And I can't think of anything bigger than statewide television with professional sounding announcers like yourself. We had Scott Inman over the years, Bobby Swofford.
Here's a shot right at third base, and that'll be a line out to the third baseman. So it's one out now here in the seventh.
Great snag there by the third baseman. But, yeah, so it's exciting. It's been a great partnership. It'll continue. Bobby will I know, say, carry the torch.
I mean, we always think about your career because you've been here, what, three, four
five.
Years? 5 years now.
Yep, five and a half.
So would you say, like, the biggest thing you've done with the AAA was this, or would you say it would be the Dragonfly with the website stuff, going digital? I mean, what would you say this one is tapped over to the second baseman? Nice flip, and he's out. Brinkley was thrown out with a flip at first base.
Well, that was one of those nice flick with the mitts.
Yeah.
That was a bang-bang play. I'm sure we'll see the replay. Obviously, a big put-out for Van Buren. They can't afford for Marion to have any more base runners as we watch it right here again.
Number five, Caleb. Yeah, it was just a nice flip, and it's just right there. I mean,
bang-bang.
Yeah, it's a good play as Caleb Catt comes up. Caleb has gotten two base hits today. And that'll be in there for a ball. But now going back, I mean, what would you say?
I would say this is one of the greatest things. You know, like I said, before we had television, but it was really local. It was Little Rock. And, you know, this is the Arkansas Activities Association.
That one's popped up to left field. We'll continue this conversation in the next half inning as that's going to do it for the seventh. Three up, three down. We head to the bottom of the seventh inning where Van Buren, if they want to win a state title, they need five runs. And you're watching the Centennial Bank State Baseball Championships on Arkansas PBS Sports.
Broadcast of this championship game is made possible by
the Electric Cooperatives of Arkansas. Over 2,500 team members across 17 local electric distribution co-ops, powering homes, farms, and industries somewhere across Arkansas. We are the Electric Cooperatives of Arkansas. Power and people.
Farmers and Merchants Bank and the Bank of Fayetteville share the mission of Arkansas PBS to enrich and empower all Arkansans. Community, dignity, respect. That's what me banking is all about. More at mebanking.com.
Since 1976, McCormick Equipment Rental and Sales has been equipping Arkansans for the tough jobs, construction equipment and rentals, service and sales, and a proud underwriter of Arkansas PBS Sports.
Local broadcast of Arkansas PBS programming is made possible in part by Community Bakery. Scratch-made breads, pastries, cakes, treats, and locally roasted coffees served daily at two locations in Little Rock, 1200 Main and 270 Shackelford.
Let me take you for a ride on the baseline.
Let's go! Baseball fans, experience the action all over again next week. Watch all the championship games at youtube.com/ArkansasPBS.
Okay, for Van Buren, they've got their 8-9-1 hitters due up with Joshua Nowotny, Devin Gaddis, and Kai Henry. If they want to win a state championship, they've got to score five runs here in the bottom of the seventh inning.
Be a tall task.
Benjamin Girard is still on the mound for Marion as the first pitch is in for a strike. That is pitch number 91 for Girard, and he came in relief.
If you're Girard, you've just got to attack the zone. Get three more outs, and you're state champs.
Here's the 0-1. Curve ball up top. Ball one. One ball, one strike. Just underway in the bottom of the seventh inning. That swung on out to short. There to get is Brinkley. He makes the throw. It's the first down.
Marion fans on their feet. They can taste a state championship.
Never had a state championship at Marion. They've been in the finals twice. So now that brings up Devin Gaddis, who has struck out three times today.
Talk about Girard, 4.2 innings pitched. He's given up five hits, one run, one earned run. Three walks, he's got five strikeouts. 92 pitches so far in this one.
That's going to be popped up on the right side. In foul territory, that's Taylor, and he'll make the catch in foul ground. Down to the final out. They go back to the top of the lineup with Kai Henry. Henry has had a heck of a day. He's walked twice. He got hit by a pitch, and then he got a base hit back in the fifth inning. He scored three times today.
you can't say enough here about Gerard. He's got zeros in the third, the fourth, the fifth, the sixth, the seventh.
First pitch to Henry. Curveball in there for strike one. Oh, one on the way. Swung on, fouled off. It's 0-2 now.
Down to their last strike. See if Gerard can bust one across the plate for a state title. Takes a deep breath there.
So the 0-2 pitch is on the way. Curveball. It's knocked away from the catcher, and it's 1-2.
Hey, when you're ahead 0-2, you don't have to throw a strike, right?
Yeah,
you can throw it out of the zone, see if he'll chase it. It's a good pitch.
So one ball, two strikes. There's two outs. Marion looking for their first state championship. Here's the 1-2. Curveball in the dirt again. It's now 2-2. Ty Henry has one of the highest on-base percentages on the entire team. Here's the 2-2. Curveball outside. It's full at 3-2.
Gerard has fallen behind now, 3-2. See if he can't. I mean, all you got to do is put the ball in play. I mean, right, all he needs is a ground ball, a pop-up.
This is pitch number 100. Fastball in there at the knee, strike three. The Marion Patriots are state champions.
How about that? In the game on a strikeout called. What a pitching performance from Gerard. Almost 100 pitches. He did end the game with 100 pitches, five strikeouts, walk three. Just a phenomenal performance to come in. Didn't get the start, but came in and got Marion their first ever state title.
And it's a fun feeling to see teams come through and get their first. And boy, they had a heck of a performance today. It was a long baseball game, but it was a ton of fun. And we will talk about this one. We'll recap it all, as well as have the trophy performance here in a moment as you're watching the Centennial Bank State Baseball Championships on Arkansas PBS Sports.
I would never be able to run as many cattle on here as I'm running now the old way I was doing it.
I'm sure there's a lot of farmers still today that think they're doing a great job, and I understand exactly why they think that, because they don't know any different. You know, it's more than dirt. It's a living, breathing ecosystem.
Well, the trophies are starting to be given out. They're going to start with the Van Buren Pointers with their runner-up trophy, and the Pointers. I mean, look, Pointers had a great season this year. I mean, they finished the year with a record of 26-6, and they have nothing to hang their heads about. They had some pitching woes to start this ball game, but they just ran into a team offensively that was better. I mean, they put up 10 hits on the board, scored 11 runs. They capitalized on some of the mistakes that the pitchers had, but they have nothing to hang their heads on, because they had a heck of a season, and they're going to get their runner-up trophy right now. Let's go over some final stats in this one. For Marion, Gage Watson went 2-for-6. Dylan Knight, 2-for-8. Chase Armstrong, 4-for-8. Connor Taylor, 4-for-8. Caleb Catt, 4-for-6. On Van Buren's side, leading the way, you had Connor Brady go 4-for-8. Kai Henry, 2-for-4. Brecken Waters, 2-for-8. And Jackson Roeder went 2-for-4.
You know, what's difficult, you can't give up seven runs in the first inning, and that was the big difference here.
That's right.
Today.
Let's check out what we got on tap for the softball game coming up. It'll be in 5A action at the softball complex. You've got the hometown Benton team taking on Greene County Tech. That will be coming up next here on Arkansas PBS Sports here in about about 12 minutes. That one will be on over at the softball complex.
Let me tell you, Benton is really good, and Green County Tech is really going to have to come playing in Benton. Benton is undefeated this year. They're going to try to continue that. Back-to-back state titles for them. Should be a great game. You need to join Bobby Swofford and Eric King as they'll have the call. But what a great performance here by Marion.
Yeah, just great performance
great
by
title.
Them. Well, Derek, I'm actually kind of glad you got to fill in because what we were talking about a moment ago, you brought all this on, and the fact that you and I got to close this thing out has been a lot of fun, man. I appreciate you for allowing me, bringing me on as one of the first ones to do these broadcasts. And, man, we're going to miss you around here, but I know you'll still be around.
Well, thank you, and I appreciate all your help. You really stepped in the beginning and helped me and helped us find good talent, people like yourself, people like I said we mentioned. We've had so many good guys come on here and call games. Our goal was to make this sound like you're watching a national televised ESPN broadcast, Fox broadcast, and that's what we try to do. And so just glad to be a part of it. Thank you for all you've done. Thank you for AETN Sports. I'm sorry. It used to be AETN Sports. Arkansas.
That's like back in the day. Yeah. So, hey, well, Derek, thank you. For Bobby Swofford, Derek Walter, I'm RJ Honk, along with everybody at Arkansas PBS. Your final in this one, Marion 11, Van Buren 6, and you're watching the Centennial Bank State Baseball Championships on Arkansas PBS Sports. With Marion Championship.